Positivism, the nature of international law, visualized. Unlike naturalism, the positivist school in international law is not based upon universal and moral principles, but on a structured legal system, created by sovereign countries in light of their interests and desires. The positivist approach evolved as the modern nation-state system emerged from the religious wars, following the Peace of Westphalia in 1648. It rejects any extra-legal factors, such as morality and politics, because it sees law as an autonomous discipline capable of fixing its own problems, without the assistance of outside sources. According to positivists, the law is an understandable system, and its rules come from a logical and structured process. Positivism blossomed at the end of the 19th century and dominated legal theory for many years. It influenced international legal doctrine and famous advocates like Dionisio Anzilotti, George Jelinek, Heinrich Triepel, and Hans Kelsen. Positivism promoted that the sovereign states enjoy the right to comply with international law according to their own legal system and free will, and that international law is created because states choose to self-control themselves, and that in case of conflict between the law and the interest of the state, the latter prevails. On the other hand, Hans Kelsen was the leading figure of legal positivism in the 20th century. He saw the law as a pure social science, as he illustrates the legal system as a pyramid, where the law is valid only as positive law, and that a norm becomes law only because it has been created in a particular procedure. In his theory, international law has a primary place, since all norms derive their validity from the existence of states, and that the existence of a state receives its validity from international law, which sets out the conditions for its creation. Positivism has nonetheless faced criticism, especially the self-restraint theory and the strict sovereign will of the state. Moreover, it is hard to accept the absence of other factors, such as morality and politics, in a system that is called to govern the relations of states within the international society.